Hi friends, in this particular lecture we are in continuation with our discussion on set theory. We are going to discuss a symmetric difference of two sets. Now suppose we have a set A and another set B, then the symmetric difference of two sets A and B would contain all those elements which are, suppose all those elements in which A and B, the values of A and B are not similar. So a symmetric difference of A and B would contain X such that X is an element of A and X is not an element of B, or X is not an element of A and X is an element of B. It means that wherever the values of A and B are not equal, then the value of A and B would be taken. Suppose how can we write symmetric difference? Symmetric difference can also be written as A union B minus A intersection B. It means that we can subtract the common elements from A union B. Suppose how can we are going to represent it, symmetric difference, using Venn diagram? Using Venn diagram, we know that suppose A union B would be represented, all the portion of A and B would be using this particular symbol. Now if we are going to subtract the region which are common between A and B, then this region would be subtracted. So the region of A only and B only would be the region of A symmetric difference B. Now if we are taking an example, now if we have the set A, the members of set A are 1, 2, 3 and 4, and the members of set B are 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now the symmetric difference of A and B would contain A only. We know that the elements 1, 2 are present in set A and 3, 4 are also present. But remember, 3, 4 are common to both A and B. So we will remove the common elements. So the only element from set A would be 1 and 2. And the element from set B would be 5 and 6. So the elements which are in symmetric difference of A and B would be 1, 2, 5 and 6. And one more important point to remember is that the symmetric difference is also called as XOR operation. You know that whatever the operations we are discussing in set theory, these are the operations which we have discussed in logic gates, that is OR gate. OR gate is very similar to our union operation, and AND gate is very similar to our intersection operation. So this particular operation is also called as XOR operation. Now what are the different properties of set difference? One important property is that set difference is commutative. It means that the order of A and B doesn't matter. Whatever the order we pick, and if you are going to find out A symmetric difference B, or you are going to find B symmetric difference A, the both values would be equal. Another point is, if you are going to represent symmetric difference in the form of set difference, if you want to represent symmetric difference in the form of set difference, then we can represent it as A symmetric difference B is equal to A difference B, A minus B union B minus A, because the only in symmetric difference the elements of A only or B only are present. Now what are disjoint sets? So as the name suggests, if we have two sets and the intersection, and we find the intersection operation between two sets and the intersection elements, it means that if we find that the intersection of two sets is phi, it means that both elements, both set does not have any common element, then those two sets are called as disjoint sets. Now the important topic is fundamental product. In set theory is fundamental product, because using this topic, using this concept, we are going to prove various sets identities, various sets relations. So what is fundamental product? Fundamental product is the disjoint region of a Venn diagram with two or more sets. Suppose we have two sets, then the fundamental region or fundamental product would be 2 to the power 2. That is 4. And if we have 3 sets, then the fundamental product would be 2 to the power 3. That is 8. Suppose in this, in our case, we have 2 sets A and B. And the elements. So now we are going to divide. We have shown the 2 sets using the this particular Venn diagram. And now in this set, we will divide the regions, the disjoint regions, using fundamental product. So we name the first region as 1, the region of A only as 1, the region B only as 2, and the region intersection of A and B as 3, and all the remaining region is 4. So using these regions, we can find out the set A, set B, and the universal set. And using those, we can prove any particular identity in set theory. We can take a particular example of this. Now, suppose we have already mentioned that if the number of fundamental products is always 2 to the power n, where n is the number of sets. If we take 2 sets, then the fundamental product would be 4. If we take 3 sets, then fundamental product would be 8. If we take 4 sets, then fundamental product would be 2 to the power 4, that is 16. Now, the important property is that if we here we have mentioned the regions, whatever the regions in the previous Venn diagram, whatever the region 1, 2, 3 or 4 we have mentioned, I have written it as, that is, 1 is A only, region 2 is B only, region 3 is the intersection, common operation, intersection operation between A and B, and the region 4 is neither A nor B. Now here, in similarly if we take three sets, then the fundamental product would be 1. If we take three sets, then the fundamental product would be 2 to the power 3, that is 8. So if you are going to divide the region in Venn diagram, the disjoint region in Venn diagram, then it would be region 1, region 2, region 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 and 8. Now what are those regions? We can write it using the different sets and different intersection and union operation. So the region 1 would be A intersection B complement intersection C complement. Region 2 would be A complement intersection B intersection C complement. In the same way, we can write all the 8 regions. So in this this particular concept is used to prove the identities in set theory. We can easily write using this particular concept. Thank you so much.